Hi, I'm Somia. I'll be going through how I would study for GCSEs if I had them this summer. By the way, these are the grades that I got for my GCSEs. It's not a flex, it's just to show you that I know what I'm talking about. And maybe the advice that I share with you will help you. I would like to start studying for GCSEs around 4 months before the first exam. This is the overall workflow. The first thing I would want to do is to make revision material, like notes or flashcards. These are the resources I used for different subjects to make my notes. All of these are either based on the specification or are from my teachers who teach the specification. This will make sure that I cover everything. I made notes to help consolidate the info, so I didn't spend ages on making them pretty. And I would not reread these notes because that is a passive way to study. Now, regardless if you have or have not made revision material, there is something I recommend all of you do, and that is to make a list of your weak topics in each subject. If you have made revision material already, you could relearn these topics. I did this by watching YouTube videos and going through the textbook and covering any learning objectives listed and making notes on them. These are the YouTube channels I would recommend. If you're going to make revision material after this video, you can use this list to go over practice questions, which I will get onto. But how do you find out your weak topics? I would go through the contents page of a textbook, and then I would look at each chapter and ask myself how well I knew this topic. I would make a list of those topics. If you don't have a textbook, the specification works just as well. One other way is to look over any mocks you have just done and look at which questions you did worse on, and by that I mean half marks or less. Find out what topic the question was on and use that to make a list. The next thing after making revision material would be to go through practice questions. I would use the questions to see how well I have improved on my weak topics. The main reason I got top grades was that if I did not get full marks for a question, I saw that as a mistake on my part, and I made sure that I would not repeat the mistake. Use the mark scheme as if it was a textbook. What can you learn from answering this question and looking at the mark scheme? I would write down what I learned onto my notes. For essay subjects, I would just plan my answer to the questions. And guess what? You can use the same principles for past papers as well. If you feel like you were short for time in your mocks, definitely try and fix that by doing the past paper under timed conditions. That was the general workflow, and I used that workflow to make a timetable as well. And I recommend that you also make a timetable. But now I have some general GCSE tips that made sure that I got top grades. The best thing to do to start exam revision is to slowly integrate it into your week alongside other schoolwork, and slowly build up the amount of revision you do to 2 to 3 hours per day over time. The things which you could do to start could be any of the following. These are some small things you can start to do to begin making time for revision. You will probably get stressed out at some point, and that is completely fine. You might just need a break. I like to play video games during GCSEs, but you could use exercise as a break, or spend time with friends and family. But if it's just a general break in the day between study sessions, I would drink water, try to stay off the screen, and walk around the house. You should focus your revision around the specification. This is what will be tested on, and is why I use these resources. You could also use the spec to break down your revision. You could get the list of topics for a subject, decide you want to make flashcards for all of them, and spread out the workload across a month. Instead of reading the textbook, I would much prefer YouTube videos or the detailed notes on physics and maths tutor. They will only mention the things you need to know. Another thing you need to make sure you do is to use time effectively. When I revised, I would hardly ever lose focus from my goal or the thing I had to tick off my list. Why? I had some form of pressure to perform. I removed distractions, and I knew if I did not revise now, I would pay for it later. A few hours of focused revision is much, much better than 8 hours of study, then phone, then study, then phone, then study, then phone. To find past papers, I would use physics and maths tutor. The actual way is to use the exam board's website, or you could ask your teacher to print some off. When planning your revision, do not forget about paper 2 or even paper 3. You would have likely just finished the mocks on paper 2 content, so I would go back to paper 1 content, then integrate paper 2 again. And then I would keep on alternating by answering practice questions or past papers after I have done my initial revision of making revision material. Then refocus on the specific paper closer to the exam day. Some key study habits are to make daily to-do lists to keep yourself focused alongside your timetable, take breaks, and do something other than study so that you can focus on or look forward to something else, like the gym. I briefly mentioned making a timetable. A timetable will help you see how much time you have left and how well you have spread out the workload. If you want to know how to make a timetable in less than 3 minutes, watch this video here.